Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. In this video series, we will go through the workflows of round-tripping between Autodesk Smoke and Davinci Resolve. This will be performed using EDLs, XMLs, and ProRes QuickTime Media. Now before we get started, there are a few guidelines that this workflow is based on. Firstly, this project is 1080 HD using 10-bit material with a 29.97 frame rate. It is imperative that the project settings of both applications match to avoid issues. Secondly, before you send anything between applications, you need to prepare the edit so that it will be easier to conform in both applications. As a golden rule, I always select the sequence clip I want to affect and press Command-D to duplicate it. I will rename the active sequence as Smoke to Resolve. You can call it whatever you want, but I always have my original to fall back on if needed. So in this sequence, we don't need the titles for grading. So you can multi-select the segments in your sequence by holding Command and clicking the segments. Just press Delete to remove the selected segments. Now there are three points I want to mention. Firstly, there are dissolves between the shots, so we need to preserve some frame handles for resolve. Secondly, there is a composite that can be flattened in the export. If you don't want that, remove the effects and edit the segments one after the other. Finally, we just need the audio soundtrack as a guide track in Resolve. So let's carry on by first exporting the audio. Select the current sequence clip in the media panel and press Command-E to export. In the export window, I will navigate to a folder that I will use. It's called Interoperability for this example. Right-click and create a new folder called Audio. Inside the Audio folder, choose to export an audio file. Set the preset to export a stereo 16-bit WAV file. Change the file name to ref_audio and press Enter. Click Export and Smoke will begin exporting the audio guide track. So with the audio taken care of, we can now publish the video media with an EDL for Resolve. With the same sequence selected, press Command-E to export again. Move back into the main Interoperability folder. Change the export mode to Sequence Publish. In the format presets, choose the EDL Publish 10-bit DPX and WAV. The DPX bit doesn't matter as we will change this to ProRes in a minute or two. Now click Show Advanced Option. Starting in the Sequence Options tab, disable Include Audio. We already exported the audio track, so this is not needed. Now let's set up the EDL folder and naming settings. The file name text box currently shows what you'll get. A folder will be created based on the sequence's name, and the EDL will be named after the sequence. Let's change that. For example, I want the folder to be called EDL. So click the pattern text box and change the name token to EDL. The forward slash indicates folders followed by the file being inserted into the folder. This will make a folder called EDL, and the smoke2resolve.edl will be placed inside. Next, we'll set up the video export settings. Change the video format from file sequence to movie. You can have uncompressed DPX files if you want, but using QuickTime means fewer files and less space. Any media with effects will be baked into the export. All the layers will be flattened down, but any edits with transitions, like dissolves, will be maintained. Finally, a default of 10 frame handles is enabled to allow for small tweaks in Resolve. Now switch to the Movie Options tab and set the media settings. Change the movie format from MXF to QuickTime. Set the compression to ProRes 422 HQ. Next, we will define the folder paths and naming conventions for the video media. Click in the pattern text box and delete everything. let's create a folder called Media and place everything in there. If you wish to create your own folder structure using the token system, then just choose the tokens and separate them with forward slashes. All I'm going to do in this case is create files with the shot number and original file name. This is so I know the order of the shots in the sequence and where they originally came from. Type S after the forward slash, which stands for shot. In the token pull-down menu, choose shot ID to add it to the file name. Now add an underscore as virtual spacing, followed by another token called shot name. So now, for example, the first shot would be named S001_clocktower.mov. So we should be all ready to go. But just as a reminder, you can save all these settings as a preset, so you can select this option if you want these settings. Now press export. Smoke will render any effects if required, and once that is done, it will begin to export the files. You can monitor this by clicking on the arrows to bring up the console. You will see each file export one at a time, and all the entries will be ticked once the export is complete. Just for verification, I will bring up the Finder and we can look at the folder structure. So inside my Interoperability folder, here is the Audio folder with the Audio Guide Track. Here is the EDL folder with the EDL. And finally, this is the Media folder containing the media files with the specified naming conventions. In the next video, I will take you through the basic conform process in Resolve and prepare the sequence for the grading stage. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning channel for future videos.